Now, clearly, I believe technology has a huge role to play in helping disadvantaged people in all forms. There are several kinds of assistive technologies we can think about. Those happen helping with sensory skills, you know, how we see. Mm-hmm. Those helping with motor skills, you know, anything to do with my limbs, hands, motion. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, those with our mental skills and how we interact with people. Mm-hmm. In each of those areas, I see technology having immense potential, and ICT in particular, with that. You know, we've seen lots of examples in the sensory case, okay, where if you have, you know, you can't see properly. Mm-hmm. I just saw some great projects at Carnegie Mellon, mm-hmm. you know, on the Braille machine and things, how you teach and how you can make progress mm-hmm. greatly, or whether it's hearing mm-hmm. and how can you automatically get sign language mm-hmm. for any document mm-hmm. to do. So clearly there are technologies there. Mm-hmm. In the areas of motor mm-hmm. skills, again, tremendous advances are taking place from prosthetics, mm-hmm. you know, that can make people feel essentially natural in mm-hmm. how they walk and take actions. Mm-hmm. You know, long term, you know, things can be connected to your brain and nerve mm-hmm. signals directly,
mm-hmm. yeah.
you know, so that people can function more appropriately. Mm-hmm. And, you know, similarly, you know, on the kind of the mental skills perspectives, I'm getting older, I always say, oh, I forget, you know, the person's name. And you can imagine where, you know, in all of those situations, you know, whether you're helping people remember things in case of Alzheimer's, mm-hmm. you can help people live longer, more productive, healthier lives. Mm-hmm. Now, what are the challenges, mm-hmm. you know, and what needs to get done to get these things out? Mm-hmm. The first, I think, is about awareness, that there is a lot of technology and capabilities that exist and how we get it out. You know, certainly as Microsoft and as a company, you know, it is high priority for us as our, you know, mainstream products are used worldwide, that we make assistive capabilities in that as a foundational part of it. But making the awareness to the people who need it, okay, is fundamental.
Yeah.
I think the second aspect is, you know, the investments that the governments themselves make in helping these technologies reach the people who need them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, whether it be in schools and work environments, because unless we do that, the productive capability of these millions or hundreds of millions of people is not getting there.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, I think what is critical is about innovation.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, there is so much scope for innovation that is still possible mm-hmm. on what we can do. You know, the Professor Hugh Hare that I was talking to at MIT, mm-hmm. you know, where he has these prosthetics that, you know, allow people to walk mm-hmm. pretty normally, mm-hmm. you know, today the price might be $1,000.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow we can bring down the price to $100.
Wow.
You know, a few years later, mm-hmm. you know, with scale, it might be tens or twenties of dollars. So mm-hmm. imagine the number of people that can be impacted.
Mm-hmm.
You know, one of the beauties of ICT, you know, with a phone device that I can continuously carry that can give a blind man direction.
Mm-hmm.
I think we can bring back, you know, both address new capabilities mm-hmm. and bring down the cost
mm-hmm.
so that it can be affordable for each and every person. So those are the three things that come to mind
yeah.
And are very important.
Thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much.